This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the properties of kites, and I'll show how we can prove those properties. So let's start with a definition. My definition says that a kite is a quadrilateral, so it's a four-sided figure, with two adjacent sides that are congruent, and the other two sides also congruent. Now, I've drawn two kites here, and they look very different. One is a convex kite. All of its interior angles are less than 180 degrees, so it's a convex polygon, and in this case, it's a convex kite. The other kite that I've drawn on the right, the one in red, is a concave kite. It's got one angle, the angle at A, which is greater than 180 degrees. Now, if we check the definition for a kite, we can find that both of these conform to that definition. They're both quadrilaterals. They've both got four sides. We want to find two adjacent sides that are congruent. Well, side AB and side AD for both of these kites are adjacent. And we're going to label them as being congruent. And then it says the other two sides are also congruent. So I'm going to label side BC and side DC congruent. I'll do that for both of the kites. And now let's look at their properties. The first property we have says that one pair of opposite angles is congruent. So it looks like angle B and angle D would be the ones we want to choose. They seem like they would be the same size. So what I'm going to do to prove it is draw a diagonal connecting A and C. I'll do that for both of these kites. Now, in both cases, what I've done is formed a new triangle. Two new triangles. I've formed triangle ABC in both cases, and I've formed triangle ADC, and I want to show that those two triangles are congruent. Well, since they both have two sides congruent at AB and AD, and two more sides congruent, BC and DC, that's true of both of them. I forgot to mark these two. And we've also got side AC shared by both triangle ABC and ADC. We've got side congruency. So those two triangles are congruent. That means the corresponding parts will be congruent. So angle B and angle D, in both cases, will be congruent angles. So we've got a pair of opposite angles that are congruent. Then the next property says that one diagonal bisects the other pair of angles. The other pair of angles is AC. Looking again at the two triangles that we've made, by drawing diagonal AC, we can see that angle BAC is congruent with angle DAC. So we've bisected angle A, and we've done that in both cases. And angle BCA corresponds to angle DCA, so they're congruent, which means we've bisected angle D. So in both cases, we have one diagonal bisecting that other pair of angles, angle A and angle C. The next property says a line containing one diagonal bisects the other diagonal. Well, in the case of the convex kite, we could just say one diagonal bisects the other diagonal. So I'm going to draw the other diagonal. And we'll go on and prove that in a second. For the concave kite, when I draw the diagonal BD, something kind of strange happens. The first thing is BD falls outside of the kite. It's a diagonal because it's connecting opposite angles, B and D. But it's not within the kite. And that's because we've got this concave kite. So the line between B and D is going to fall outside of the kite. The other thing is that it's not intersected by the other diagonal. So what we have to do is we have to extend the other diagonal. We're going to extend AC until it intersects BD. This is why the property says a line containing one diagonal. Diagonal AC doesn't bisect BD, but we may be able to show that the line containing AC bisects BD. Okay? Now, let's take that point of intersection in both cases and label it. We'll call it E. And now I want to look at triangle ABE and triangle ADE in both cases. So I've got triangle ABE and triangle ADE. And see if we can prove that they're congruent triangles. I know that side AB is congruent with side AD. I know that angle BAE is congruent with angle DAE. That's for the convex kite. And we know that both of these triangles, ABE and ADE, share side AE. So we've got, at least for the convex kite, two congruent triangles. Let's look at the concave kite for a second. Once again, I know that AB is congruent with AD, and both of those triangles share side AE. As for angle BAE and DAE, we can prove that those are congruent angles because they're both supplementary angles to congruent angles. Okay, we've got those congruent angles inside the kite at A, and we've got the supplementary angles which are outside. So those supplementary angles, BAE and DAE, must be congruent. Therefore, in both cases, I've got two congruent triangles, ABE and ADE. If they're congruent, that means that BE is congruent with DE. So BD, which was the diagonal, has been bisected in one case by the other angle, by the other diagonal, AC, in the other case by the line containing the diagonal AC. But in both cases, I've bisected that diagonal. And the last thing we've got to show is that lines containing diagonals are perpendicular to each other. So in other words, for the convex kite, I want to show that those two diagonals are perpendicular to each other. Well, angle AEB is congruent with angle AED. Both of those angles share a common side and fall along a straight line. They form a 180-degree angle, so they must both be right angles. So therefore, these two diagonals are going to be perpendicular. And we can show the same thing for the concave kite as well. Okay? So the lines containing the diagonals are going to be perpendicular to each other. And I guess that's it for kites. Take care. I'll see you next time.